In this edition of Minute GarageBand, we're going to show you how to lock tracks. In versions of GarageBand prior to version 6, the track header contained 5 buttons. Version 6 sought to simplify the interface by hiding 2 of these buttons by default, one of which was the track lock button. In order to lock a track, simply use the track menu and select the Show Track Lock menu item. Now you can click the lock icon in any track, and the next time you play the project, all locked tracks will be rendered to disk before playback begins. Now the question is, what purpose is served by locking a track? To understand that, you need to understand how an unlocked track functions. For a software track, your Mac has to generate the instrument, play the notes, and then apply any effects you have added as the track is being played back. In other words, in real time. This can require a lot of computing power and may limit the number of tracks and/or effects that you can use. For a real instrument track, while the instrument doesn't need to be generated, all the effects need to be rendered in real time. When you lock a track, all the work of generating an instrument or rendering an effect is performed ahead of time and saved to disk as a high-resolution 32-bit file called a freeze file. This means that when you play back the project, all the computer has to do is read the file from disk, so there's minimal processing being done. Additionally, once a track is locked, you can't accidentally move or delete any regions within the track. Should you find the need to make additional edits, however, you can unlock the track, edit your original recordings, and then relock it to render out a new high-resolution freeze file. We hope you found this video useful, and for more, subscribe to our YouTube channel for new and updated GarageBand videos every week. Thanks for listening!